So hello and welcome to episode, I believe it's 10 of the Forza Horizon Let's Play. And let's go to this real quick. I need a C-class car. Yeah, I didn't do much in between these episodes. Like, it's been a couple of days since I've recorded one, but I didn't do anything. So I haven't done anything that I screwed up on. So, yeah, I don't have the Challenger from What's-His-Face, or whatever. Manual with clutch. Here, right about now. Save. Hey! So which way am I going? I think I'm going up this way. Let's see. No. Go to the right. I like the arrow, because I can just look at it and decide which way I need to go. Yes, you've said this many times. I have ignored you many times also. I can go up here. I think this has to be my favorite C-Class car. I don't know why I like this car so much, and I crashed it. Awesome. There's an Impala. I have one of those. It's a B-class.
It's awesome.
Enter event. Let's see. Where's my Impala at? There it is. Let's see. You know what? I haven't used this car since, like, the first episode, so I'm going to use it. Just screw it. I need to hear that. I want to see. I can see how far I've gotten through the game, but I'm kind of curious. That made absolutely no sense what I just said. Yeah, I'm gonna try and get this episode out before I leave. Or, yeah, about that. Oh, that's that guy! I remember that guy from the very beginning! Hi, I get to meet you in my, Corrado again. But it's the one douche guy from the very beginning. Escapa. He's gonna escape. You know what's funny? I had a Spanish teacher last year that instead of saying escape, she said just scape. Like, oh god. Why does this car sound like the Mazda RX-8 to me? I'm honestly very curious. Nice. Get up there. Oh, Jesus. He smacked me into the wall. This doesn't sound like a regular Corrado. Get out the way. Duke McGuire. Oh, yeah, McGruber. I wonder if Gruber is in this race. I don't think Gruber is in this race. That was hilarious. I didn't even know there was a guy named Gruber in the race. This car sounds like a mix between a Mazda RX-8 and like a Volkswagen. That is so weird. Hey, I'm 60th place. Nice. Would you get out the way? Okay, so first thing I want to talk about that... just talking about the game is getting kind of boring. And I actually have a little bit to talk about. But, I don't know about if you guys have known, but... there's going to be new DLC release for this on the 6th of November. And it has to be... it includes two cars that I wanted in Forza Horizon that weren't in there. Hey, hit the wall again. Nice. But it has... off the top of my head, I can remember the Jeep Wrangler Rubicon, the one off of Forza 4, which I will have a lot of fun with. The Nissan 240SX off of Forza 4. The 91 or whatever it was. Okay, I gotta catch up to this douche. Get back here, douche! And... I think it has a Lamborghini Gallardo... one of those Performante, something like that. Spider convertible. It has a... is that the one that has a Gumpert? The like, super-duper epic one? Get back here, McGruber! Okay, so it's 3 out of 4 laps, so I have 1 lap to redeem myself. and I gotta pass this douche. But yeah, it's got like one more car, but I can't remember off the top of my head. Oh, it's they have one of those Shelby Mustang 1000s, the one that has 1,000 horsepower, and it goes over like 200 miles per hour. It's like a memorial basically to Carroll Shelby because he passed away earlier this year. And I cannot wait to get that pack. And then it gets better. Sometime, I don't know what the December car pack is going to be that's going to be released. I think they're always usually released on like the first Tuesday of every month. I've noticed that about Forza DLC. They've done that since Forza 3. But, hi, win. Yay. But supposedly on December 18th, they're releasing a rally pack, rally add-on to this game, which will be so much fun. I love rally. And they had a picture on ForzaPlanet.net. I'll try and remember to put the link in the description to the article. But it says it's supposed to bring in like a couple new cars. I'm betting that there's gonna be that Audi Quattro that was the Pikes Peak one, the Rice Millen Genesis, the Honda Hyundai Genesis. What are these? B Euro. Oh, I don't want that. I want that. 70 C-Class. C-Class in general. Oh, it must be U.S. I can use my Raptor. I haven't even used that since I bought it. Car class must be B or below. You know, I think I'm gonna do that one. I'll set that real quick and then. Oh, I don't wanna go there. There. I don't care if I have to pay 10,000 credits. I have 600 and something thousand. Actually, no, I'm gonna change my car here. Oops. Not paint shop, change car. Oh, and if you're a big painter and you still don't have this game and you're watching this episode, I'll show you what cool stuff they've added in the paint shop. Oh, what car do I want to use? I'm not gonna lie, I kinda wanna use the Impala. Let's see which one's got the best handling. Apparently, the Mustang's actually better because it has better braking. I'm gonna go ahead and I'll use the Impala. It sounds fun. But I know how many people wanted matte paint in Forza 4. Hold on, it's got to load. I guess you can already guess what I'm gonna show you in a second. Design creator, paint car, paint body. Look at this. You got your normal colors, which are just gloss. You got metallic, which is cool. I think I'm actually gonna paint this car. It looks pretty good in black. And then you have the matte. It actually looks like real matte too, real matte paint. It looks so awesome. I should make it pink. Matte pink 64 palette. No, can't do it. I don't know. I'm gonna pretend to my windows because I'm a gangsta. I'm a badass. I just said that. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know about that. Oh, I didn't look at the. Hold on. I never look at the time that I start this, and I want it to be less than 20 minutes at least. Maybe 18 minutes or so. So it's been about 9 minutes so far, so I'll go for 10 more minutes. Let me look at my phone. 7:31, so. Oh, 7:40, I'll stop. And you can also import your Forza 4 decals. Not the full car paint though. I guess because they took out a lot of cars, so like you won't be able to put on a 92 Ford Escort. So I just followed the line on my road. This car is gonna be awesome. I remember I loved this car in Midnight Club 3 and Los Angeles. I love this car. I'm glad to see it back in a new. Ooh, barn find. Oh wow, that's where I somewhat came from. I think I know where that one is. But I'm gonna get it later. Wow, I got 50. Wow, that's amazing. But, like I've been saying, I've been posting lots of little gameplay videos, like of random cars, lots of cool cars, on my, my main channel, which is Test Drive 426 without the LPS. What's that go to? Oh, it's that parking lot. And I've been posting all the barn finds, like whenever I first find them, posting all those videos on there. So you should go check it out if you haven't. It's on this channel page. This thing will barely even slide because I got awesome. Oh, it's gonna turn dark. I've wanted to see this car with light, how the lights work. Kind of curious. I always, like, it's weird. I'll be around my house, I'll be thinking about something, and I'll think of, I don't know, but something, I'll think of something, I'll go, curious. Because it's like that. Ooh, a Jaguar E-Type. I kind of want one of those, but they're kind of expensive. I want a Yukon, too. Wait, I can't get a Yukon. That sucks. I've seen these people who mod games, like, at all in the first, like, 4 days that the game's out. Just need to get a life. I don't want that. Just need to get a life. And yes, if you're watching this video and you're one of those people, I mean you. Because I absolutely hate seeing, oh, mods and blah, blah, blah on freaking YouTube. Like I said, two days after the game's released. And it's just so stupid. Why would you need to mod a brand new game? Play the game first, then I don't even recommend modding on the Xbox because it will get you banned. So that's a word of advice. Modding on the PC is okay as long as, well, mining on the PC doesn't really matter anyways. Like, I have my Grand Theft Auto 4 modded to where I can get anything, and I'm invincible and all that. That's the trainer and all that. But it's fun. I mean, I didn't buy the game for the computer to play through the career. Or whatever you want to call it. That's why I have it on the PS3. What car is that? Is that an S2? No, it isn't. I was going to say, is that... Oh, God. That hurt. Ooh, nice. Ultimate skills challenge. How much do I have now? 706K. Come on, 64 Impala. We got this, man. It's going to tick me off if I don't win. Like, seriously. I want a wheel for my Xbox, kind of. I've heard good and bad things about the Microsoft wireless racing wheel. But I think if I got one, it would be that, because they're getting pretty cheap now. And, oh, you douche. And, I already have a steering... I have a actually, it's $160 steering wheel for my PS3 and my computer. I got one of those, Fanatic Porsche 911 Carrera wheels. I love it. It's awesome. But I'm kind of sad because, like, a couple months ago, the cable that goes from the wheel to the shifter, like the H shifter, it broke. Like, the end of it broke. So I still haven't gotten a new one. I think I'm gonna order one soon because they have them on their website for like $2 or something like that. But it's a double-ended, like, S video cable. Well, not S video. PS2. Like, old mouse and keyboard plugins to back in computer. If you don't know what that is, look up PS2 mouse, like PS2, like PlayStation 2 abbreviated. I hate how you can't see the gauges, like, in any cars during the day in this game. Except for if, like, the sun is perfectly, like, I can barely see the bottom of the tachometer. But if the, if the gauges are lit up, like in the Boss 302 Mustang, that car is awesome. I love it. Like I said, I got that deal, that first DLC pack. So I got that car. I got the Aventador J, which I don't even. That car is just ugly. I can't stand it. Like, the regular Aventador is actually pretty good looking, but that, I just don't like it at all. It looks like a KTM Expo, honestly. That would be awesome if they added one of those in here. Hey, I'm 59th, yay. I should go crunching, grinding. Crunching. Yes, because that's totally what I'm going to do. I need to go crunching. But, I should go grinding in my Toyota Truino and just drift around in the circle like I usually do, and I get 25,000 on each one I can link together like that. Oh, it'd be awesome to drift it through here. I should try that. That didn't work. This car does not want to drift. It's got super uber tires on it. I would like to have a 96 Chevy Impala SS, honestly. I like those a lot. I like it. I like it a lot. That's what that made me think of. Aw, I was gonna sideswipe that, but that guy hit it. MacGruber. MacGruber. So yeah, I put up a, if you haven't seen it, I put up a another episode of my Let's Play of Forza Horizon, or not, I'm playing Forza Horizon, Forza Motorsport 2 yesterday, which would have been Thursday, if you're not seeing this on this Friday, the 2nd. So, oops, what do we have? What time is it? Oh, it's that time. It's exactly 7:39. Well, I guess but I hope you guys enjoyed this longer episode of Forza Horizon Let's Play. Be sure, actually it's not really that much longer because it's almost 17 minutes right now. I'm going to try and get this done before 7 minutes. Rate and subscribe, and I'm out of here. See ya.